Happy?
Yeah.
Alright guys, it's Saturday. What's the date today? And we are going to continue with this trailer. First this morning, we're going to get the heat gun out, rip up all the vinyl because it's glued down, rip up all the timber so it's just a bare trailer frame, clean up all the edges with the grinder, as you can see. Gonna clean up all this because that's the frame of the trailer in behind there. All this glue and stuff still there, so we'll clean all that up. Probably take it back outside, give it a wash, just clean it up completely, see what it looks like, and probably get some spray paint. Ah yeah, cool. So I think we're just gonna get straight into it. Finished the ripping up all the vinyl, all there. Ripped up off all, ripped off all the timber. That's out there. April's doing some stuff on the comp, sorting out all the spicks and specks. Now I'm just about to rip up all the tin. Get all that up. That will take us back to the bare frame. I'll show you that right now. So yeah, that's all the bare frame there. Clean all this up. So when the new panels get made, there's actually, they put this, oh, what did you call it? You can call it an L angle, because it's like an S angle. It's like shaped like this, and then like that. So, when that you can see there, that's actually the other lip to this angle. So we'll glue all through here, and then the new panel will actually be able to sit perfectly on that there underneath when this comes off. So when we're installing it, it'll be a lot easier. But yeah, you can see they just, back in the day, they just glued everything and they screwed everything. But this one will just be glue everything, so. Apparently this glue, if you put it on and you get it wrong, it's staying there. There's no taking it off. There's no second time. It's just, you gotta get it perfect the first time, because when this stuff cures, it's like rock. I'll actually put a link down in the description of this guy doing it with a forklift, trying to actually peel two bits of fiberglass apart, and it just won't do it. Like, yeah, you should watch that. It's pretty cool. What else are we gonna do? We'll be able to see where all the plumbing is under the trailer. Have a look at these water tanks, see if they're holding up all right. Yeah, and just clean all this up a lot. Like, it's pretty, yeah, how you going? Things gas in there or something. But yeah, it's coming along. Can't wait to get a coat of paint on it though. Then we'll be moving. April's just going to Bunnings.
See ya.
Bunnings, get off of Bunnings.
Yeah. Get out of here. About to hose down this. You watch Frankie, she's about losing mine. Oh no, Frankie. He loves the hose. And if you have a look at down there, that's how much dirt was caught in the petrol tank, in the water tank. It's caked in there and back there as well. So much. Bit of red dust. Oh, what's your head? Bit of dirt.
Just on me good old wire brush, trusty wire brush. Just gonna go cleaning the inside of these. it's all rusty and stuff like that. So just gonna get out a good brush and then it'll be nice to give it a paint later. Maybe tomorrow, who knows how long it'll take us to clean it up, but that's the plan.
Hopefully it's done today.
I know. But yeah, good. Sometimes I brush good, good. We brush your hair with it too. It's nice. Oh, I'm really getting to get rid of all the knots.
Easy, man. Come on, can't just fake it.
Oh, it's nice. Nice.
Yeah, I'll do it for you.
No, you will not. I'll do it for you.
Yeah, get the kills. That's better. That's
what
way
does that
better.
Feel like?
It feels nice.
Does it really?
Yeah, real like sharp against the skull.
You look crazy.
Yeah, it does a good style. Noir style.
Yeah, so that's it. I'm going to sit you down. So this is how you do it.
On a serious note though, we've literally stripped everything off the base, taken all suspension out. That was pretty easy. It was 3 bolts here, then I think, 3, then 6 bolts up there, and that just dropped straight out all together. That's the heaviest part of the trailer, that was. We're gonna strip it all back. So it's all pretty good. There's just surface rust here and there, in here and stuff like that. It won't take long. Strip it all back, couple coats of paint, and then it will be looking mint. Get all this old glue off. What else? Left all the gas line in, because that will be where the oven will go. We used to stand up here, go up through there into the door, but I'm gonna grind all that out and put the new door's gonna go here. So that'll literally just weld straight in there. So we'll weld that up. I'm gonna take all this off. It's like trying to explain something and like your kid, he's like just running in the background. You're like, stop it, Johnny, stop it.
That's April, she's just going silly.
I think because she's like, oh, not another renovation. Yeah. I dragged her through a house reno, now I'm dragging her through a caravan reno.
I am hard work. Massive hard work.
Look at that. How many wheat bix do you do?
21.
I'm actually going to cut all this off through this section or through here. Because Styromax say 50mm minimum to glue to. Might be a bit bright that way.
Oh, we also forgot to take you there too. Sorry. You'll see
we still got to go there.
Oh, we do. True. You have to wait and see.
So yeah, 50mm minimum. You're being stupid. I know you are. So I'm going to weld a bit more, bit of fatter steel through there. Yeah, that's about it. I think we better get into it.
Yeah, so we'll sit down and put some time lapse on.
Alright, so I've just cut off all the old braces for the side because they sat like this, and as you can see, there was like a 4mm gap underneath, and all it used to do was collect dust all the way through. Especially here, this is where all the trailers earth to, and that's just wet clay dirt. So the plan is get steel 60mm thick or 70, I can't remember what this is, and then piece that all the way through. Same thickness as this down the sides, instead of having this crap flimsy shit sitting there like that, and then dust getting in there, which is just a stupid design anyway. So yeah, got rid of that. April's been tucking into these little C sections in here, getting in that. And yeah, flowing. Should be done before you know it.
Oh mate, I'm out of drown. Maybe. Oh, Mr. Spidey's moved. Mr. Spidey's moved. He's having a bit of a sunbake, I reckon. I don't normally do this, I don't really like spiders, but let's see if we can save him. I need a long stick. A long stick. Last thing I want is him to crawl up the thing. I will literally skip. I'll skip.
Go!
Run! Dry the legs! Run! Run! Dry them legs. His back legs are like paralyzed.
Run.
Do you have a boyfriend that does stupid shit like throw bugs on you or like just, I don't know, just do shit that you know you're going to be scared of or that you're not going to like? You understand why I
make $80,000 to get you there if you know these four celebrities.
He does that kind of shit.
Listen.
You know the hustle out of play for your guest last hour.
Alright, well I tried. Alright, we've finished spray painting. Pretty much everywhere that matters. Well, everywhere's been spray painted, but we've really looked up.
What do you mean everywhere that matters? Everywhere matters.
Yeah, okay, yeah. So we've done that. Yeah, everything's been spray painted. So yeah, that's all done. And now we gotta fix up this rusty old thing. Rusty old thing. What do you reckon? It'll be rusty. The old girl. She used to be red. But now she's gonna be what colour? Torno?
Sandy Torpe.
That's the plan. We're actually gonna go pick up a, what are they called? A compressor spray paint thing this afternoon from off old mate from Gumtree. Bloody good Gumtree. Yeah, that's the plan. So yeah, pretty happy with that. It's actually come up really well compared to what it looked like yesterday. I'll get some close-ups for you. Oh yeah, that's freaking nice. Look at the old girl. You slap her up. Yep. Looking good. Looking good. Oh, shot out. Oh my god. Hole in one. Also, you're probably wondering why Jack's haircut has changed since the last time you may have seen his face. I was giving him a haircut yesterday and I was doing a YouTube tutorial on how to fade. Anyways, I think people are gonna wonder what happened to your hair. Well, Barbara did it. Me.
Good.
It looks like a mushroom. To be honest, you didn't let me finish it. So, yeah, I have to fix that up. Can't have my boy walk around looking like a mushroom. To be honest, look, I'll be honest, it's gotta be real. I accidentally stabbed him in the back of the head with the clippers and he had enough. So we left it there for the night. I need to finish it. Not sure when he'll let me, but oh well. Sorry, honey.
I'm taking all the, brakes off at the moment. These are just dirty old drum brakes. So the way these work is they're electric as well. So when we put our brake on in the car, it sends a signal down to these and they sort of slap on in sense. The drum brakes aren't a really good braking system. They've been around for years. I mean, cars and your Barina's got drum brakes in the back of it.
Oh, okay.
So cars still use them and stuff like that, but the modern way to do it is disc brake, where you have two calipers in it and the disc in between. So when your tire's spinning, your calipers grip like this and it will slow your wheel down. And it's a more consistent braking than your brakes trying to go outwards like this. So hopefully, I'm hoping that I can get something that will bolt onto these axles and I'll be able to install some disc brakes on this. Because the drum as well, you can see in there, they're super heavy.
Yeah, so they were, weren't they?
If we can, get rid of them and put some discs on here, that would be unbelievable.
Mm.
But, I mean, yeah, vans, cars, trucks, boat trailers, trailers in general, they all have these still to this day, so it's just not a nice pull-up. Like, we've been in the car before, and we'll touch around a corner, or touch the brakes and just lock us up.
Yeah, it's not nice. It's
not a good feeling, especially when you're towing.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we're just doing that, and that'll all be off, and I think we'll... The last couple of days have just been cleaning up and setting up this our new house. Check it. Full size windows. Really good structural integrity. Wooden blown away in a strong wind. Easy access door. Open. Close. Open. Close. And then workshop. So it's probably only like about a, I don't know, 2 second commute to work, which is really handy. Usually, you know, stuck in traffic, red lights, green lights, red, yellow lights, all the lights. But we are cleaning up the wheels. They're all being cleaned up now. Why is it four? Oh yeah, five. Clean up all these springs. This is what the old dirty one looked like. Just all surface rust again. Clean them up, give them a wash. Give them a paint. April's busy on the comp. What you doing?
I'm just getting all the finer details for our YouTube video to get uploaded later.
Nice. You're doing the hard work. All the labour intensive stuff, hey?
Yeah, hectic stuff.
And then we've cleaned up this frame here. This is where all the suspension runs. We're gonna start grinding that up, I reckon. Taking all the surface rust off that, and then hopefully we can get the whole van back in here and forget about being outside, because it's a bit of a pain in the ass. Get in here, start putting the flooring on, all the suspension back in, tidy up what we have to with the frame. All right, so April's gone away for the weekend. She's left me with it like a bit of an alien, but I'm painting the suspension at the moment. These are all rusty and stuff, all a bit hard done by, so we've cleaned them right up. They're the springs. So yeah, they're just all rusty and stuff. This is the what it all sits in. So that's the color we're going. They're all primed up, ready to go. Now, my old man is actually panel beater spray painter by trade, so you'd think I would have grown up spray paint and stuff, but I actually never have. So this is my first time actually using a compressor and a gun. Let's get into it. So this is the stuff, then I put it on it. It's a protective coating rather than just doing paint. It's hardener, and that's the color there, hardener there, and that's the mixture that we put it through. So run that, compressor, blower, and then it actually just twists into there and sits in there like that. But I'll show you that in a second. And then you just spray it on, and they're coming up pretty good compared to what they were. Bloody finished. Finished the springs, the suspension arms, the suspension frame. All coated. It's looking good. And like, it's real cool coating. It's like a rubber texture. goes on like really thick. Yeah, super easy to use, which is good. Give you guys a bit of a close up. You can kind of see the finish that it has. It's not like a flat finish. It's more a durable, bumpier finish. I don't know if they're the right words, but whatever. And yeah, so underside and top side's done. All that's done and the springs are done. So now I've just got to wait until the shock absorbers come, but I reckon tomorrow I'm gonna start putting it back together. We're coming up to our third week. This morning I installed the new DO35 hitch. So yeah, just a bigger, better upgrade from the last ones, the old tow ball and couple. This actually, if I get this off here, pins in, get that out there like that. So yeah, pin comes up through here and then it locks on like that. So it can't go anywhere, rather than, yeah, your tow ball and then that ball going over top of it. And then this has got a roll system. So if your caravan was to roll in an extreme event, which everyone hopes that that just would never happen, your car won't roll with it because this is continuous 360. So that's pretty cool. So that's gonna go on there. Hopefully today I'm gonna get all the wheels and everything back on this. Just chucking all the suspension arms on now, like this. I'm gonna keep all the bolts just rusty. I'm not gonna bother tidying them up. I don't see the need, they're good, they're fine. I'll just spray them with a bit of WD-40. I think it'll look pretty cool too, like everything looks up to date, and then you'll just have these bolts just all rusty, and same with the chains and stuff. Just leave them like that. I reckon they'll look pretty good. Plus, nothing's wrong with them, so that's fine. Yeah, so that's the plan today. Get it all back together, try and remember where all the bolts go, and get it back in here. Fingers crossed. And this is what it's looking like. So I just put the wheels back on temporarily. They're gonna have to come back on anyway, off anyway, to put the disc brakes on, but I'm about to try and get it underneath the frame there. Bolt it all back up, and then yeah, bring it back in here. And then it'll be out from outside. This is the setup we've got going on. I've got two high lift jacks, both sides. And I gotta line these bolts up with that L plate that comes out, and these three points with the three L's that come out that side. And I've got to be able to clear them guards, which it's looking like I'm going to be able to do now. She's a bit wobbly though, a bit sketchy. But it's going to be in there in a couple of minutes. So that brings you to the end of another caravan build. We've got her back in the shed. The end of a caravan build episode, definitely not the end yet. So rear bars back on, got the spare tire guy there, which is all done. It's gonna help too, having that on. So when we put this panel on, we got something to rest it on. Jerry cam will go there, got the water tanks back in. All that's in there, looking good. April's wheels are coming up really nice too. I didn't film any of this, but I spent I don't know, a couple of hours the other day welding this exterior frame on. So yeah, that's where we'll glue, and that's where the frame will just stick straight to the side of there, and then we'll clamp it. So yeah, done that, the run there, that side, and identical the other side. What are we doing now? So picked up some new shocks as well. So these were the old ones, and these are the new ones. They're actually a little bit taller.
Is that gonna matter?
It won't matter, but just a tiny bit taller. I have to change the bushes out because they're a bit thinner. Yeah. So yeah, thanks heaps again for watching, and I hope you guys are liking this build. And
hope you're even like, yeah, learning a little bit, or you know, we're answering along the
some video questions along the way.
Curiosity you're having, I hope that we're, I don't know.
Yep, so also, yeah, we hope we've given you some motivation too, to maybe you got something that's old and you can give it a good old revamp, because there's plenty of good old stuff out there that will only need, you know, a little bit of maintenance and you can get it looking really good. So, and we're really happy with TCL. How this is coming along. And what's it been? It's only been
3 weeks.
Nah. First week? 2 weeks. It's only been 2 weeks. This is the third week.
Feels like it's a couple.
So this has been only been 2 weeks and we've stripped everything and we've got it back looking like this. So for us, the hard work is done and now it's time to go up with it.
Something like that.
Build it.
So we'll see.
Thanks again and we'll catch you next time.
Bye.
Clean up all the edges. We clean up all this because that's the frame. Clean all that up. Yeah, and just clean all this up a lot. Like, it's pretty... Clean all this up. So we're nearly done cleaning it up and then we're going to hit it with some paint. Going to clean up all the wheels and tires and clean up all these springs. Clean them up, give them a wash. And we've cleaned up this frame here. Yeah, cleaning up the wheels. Just clean it up completely. So April and I are just going to stand here whilst you guys subscribe to this channel. Subscribe. See you later.
Bye.